Do you want to save money and time by transferring college credits with CLAP? If you want to make sure that you pass your CLAP chemistry exam, then this video is for you. I'll walk you through various strategies to make sure that your efforts will not be wasted, so be sure you stay until the end. The first thing you want to do is set your target. You want to figure out what's the required CLAP score for the school that you're interested in. Let's say it's Purdue. So Google Purdue University CLAP. Make sure that it's the official link for the school. Now you can see that Purdue provides 3 credit hour transfer for CHEM 11100, and to get that you need at least 50 plus on your CLAP chemistry score. So if that's what you're going after, your target score is going to be 50 and above. If you're eyeing to transfer 4 credit hour, then you're going to need 65 plus. And if you're eyeing for the 8 credit hour, then you're going to need 70 plus from the maximum score of 80. Well, that makes sense since you're transferring a whole lot of credit. I'm not sure if you know this, for a 3-credit college course in 2020 was $1,677. Imagine paying just $89 for those credits. It's such an amazing deal. So the next question is, what does it mean to get a 50 plus score? It definitely doesn't mean getting 50% of the questions right. So to answer that question, we're going to look at the official guide from College Board. For chemistry, you have 90 minutes to answer 75 multiple choice questions with 5 options. That works out to be slightly over a minute per question. Also, it uses writes-only scoring. That means only correct answers will give you points, and there is no penalty for getting an answer wrong. So the questions that you answer incorrectly, it will not be factored into your score. While in plain English, this just means don't leave any questions empty. If you're running out of time or you don't know the answer, guessing is going to be a better strategy than to leave it blank. Let's say out of the 75 questions, you answered 53 correctly. That's your raw score. Now, you won't get to see this score because it'll be automatically converted into a skilled score, and that ranges from 20 to 80. How the conversion works going from raw score to skilled score is not disclosed. However, one of the reasons for using a skilled score rather than a raw score is because there are multiple versions of the same exam, and not all of them are 100% equal in terms of difficulty. Some versions might be harder or easier. To make it fair to everyone, they go with a skilled score to take into consideration how other people do on each version of the exam. So let's use a hypothetical example. You sit for the exam in January and you got 53 questions correct out of the 75. And that's a 70%. You walk out with a skilled score of 55. Now, you're not happy with the score. You think you can do better, so you're going to retake it in May. By the way, you shouldn't repeat an exam of the same title within 3 months of the last exam date. If you're going to repeat an exam, make sure it's 3 months later. So now in May, you walk in and you take the exam again. And let's just say you perform the same. You got 53 correct and that's 70%, but this time your skill score is 60. So what gives? In the past, people who took the first version of the test usually get better scores. So it's considered as easier. Whereas for the second version of the exam that you take in May, usually people score worse. So it's considered as harder. So therefore, the skilled score is higher, even though you got the same number of questions correct in both attempts. Now, this is obviously just a hypothetical example. If your goal is to get at least 50 on your CLAP chemistry, I'd say you want to make sure that you score at least 70% in your practice test. Now, this is based on the results that's reported by others who have already taken the exam. Before you figure out where to get that 70% from, do give this video a thumbs up if you're getting value out of it so far. Do share it with others who need this info as well. For chemistry, there are 9 main topics altogether. The percentage next to the main topics indicate the approximate percentage of exam questions on that topic. It's just an approximate, it doesn't mean that we're going to get exactly 20% on structure of matter. But we can use that to approximate the number of questions we're going to get on the paper. So out of 75 questions, we're expecting 15 for structure of matter, so on and so forth. If you start nailing down these topics, you're going to be well on your way to get that 70%, because in fact, these total up to 56 questions, which is going to give us 75% of the exam. Am I saying to only focus on these 5 topics and ignore the rest? Of course not. What I meant is prioritize your energy on mastering these 5 topics first, and then use your remaining time and energy on the rest of the topics. The best way to master these topics is to try out practice questions. I've created a playlist of 10 chemistry practice questions that are in line with CLAP syllabus. Definitely do check them out. I'll see you over there.